Good morning, honey. It's me. I just wanted to make a quick video since I'm going to be putting this on YouTube for you. It's early morning on November 8th. It's election day. And me and your dad and the girls, because they're out of school, because here we vote in schools, we're all going to go and vote. And it's just times like this that are really hard because we're all going out as a family, but we're still missing a big part of our family. And I know that if you were here today, you would love to go with us too, because you went with me when I voted for Bernie in the primaries, and you love talking to all the people. And today, like, the people that are out this year are crazy. Donald Trump's people are crazy, and Hillary Clinton's people are crazy. And I just know that if you were with us, that you would have so much fun out there, and you would just love meeting all the people. And it's going to be really hard to go out there and not have you with me. But I hope that wherever you are, that you're safe and that you're happy and that you are going to be watching the election tonight, and that everything's going to be the way that our country is going to need to go. But I love you and I miss you, and I just really wish that you were with us today. But you're not. So wherever you are, I hope you're safe, and I really wish that you would just let us know that you're safe and that you're okay, because not knowing that you're safe and worrying that you're hurt. A couple days ago, there was a man in South Carolina who was found. He had a woman chained up in a storage container, tied up like a fucking dog. And they have found like 7 or 8 bodies on this guy's land. And now, like before, I liked serial killers before, so I would have been interested in that story before. But now, every time they find a body, I'm like, please don't let that be you. So that's what I'm going through. So if you're out there and you're okay, just please, just comment on the video. Anonymously comment on this video and let me know that you're okay. Because I need to know that you're safe. Go vote.
Nothing compares to you. Keep the silence.
Oh, wait. Okay, this song, like, really reminds me of you, because nothing compares to you, and since you've been gone, I pretty much just floundering around like Sinead O'Connor.
Can't stop trying to see my name on the blimp.
This is more me.
You know what I mean, I'm out of the world, double up. When I'm playing around, it's your bat laid down. Didn't know me, anyone, but you know me now. I'm the young Harlem.
Now, this is Mace, remember? He quit to become a minister, didn't make any money, and then came back to the rap game.
I don't
know what they want from me. It's like the more money we come across, the more problems we see. I don't know what they want from me. It's like the more money we come across, the more problems we see.
Ready?
I am happy, I am safe, I am strong, I am filled with kindness, I am deeply loved by my Heavenly Father and by my parents, I am truly blessed, and please be with Gogo and Nana and Adam and Liz and Itty Bitty. And mom and dad.
And mom and dad.
And me and
my
sister.
And me and my sister.
And please bring Hailey back home safe and soon. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, I love the song. You love the song too. This is what about don't go stepping on my back door.
Take care if I find you've been creeping around my back stairs. You've been looking like a queen in a sailor's dress.
So basically his girl is fucking around on him, and he's saying to the guy, if I catch you in my back stairs, I'm gonna kill your ass. And this was from the 70s. Shit. They was gangster back then. Gordon Lightfoot is a motherfucking gangster, girl. Shit. Who knew? I didn't know. This satellite radio with all these great fucking stations, and I got nobody to enjoy it with.
I miss you. I miss our adventures. I miss doing bad wolf things with you. I miss going shopping with you. I miss laughing and having a good time with you. No one else gets me like you do. No one else gets my sense of humor like you do. No one else understands me like you do. No one else is there for me the way that you were. And I want my daughter, my baby, and my best friend back. Please.
Hey, Hailey. So it's me, Shauna, your mom. And I am out in the car, as always. And I'm actually at McDonald's. See, look, McDonald's. And I'm getting food. Well, I'm getting tea because I'm getting Jack in the Box for the girls because they like the breakfast there because you got them hooked on the breakfast jacks. So I'm at the Jack in the Box, and the Jack in the Box has no tea. Their tea machine is broken. And I'm like, well, I gotta have my fucking tea. So, you know, right by Emily's, I'm at the Jack in the Box right by Emily's, and there's a McDonald's right there. Remember we were here that day that they're like, power was out or something, that McDonald's. So I pull up to the McDonald's, and they're like, we can only sell you a half a gallon of tea for $1.99, where a gallon of tea is $2.99. So $1.99 plus $1.99 equals $4, not $3. So I'm like, no, because they only have half gallon containers. So I'm like, no, I don't want to pay a dollar more just because you don't have the containers that you need to have. That is messed up. And the guy's like, ma'am, I don't understand. I can't find the button. And please, will you just please take the 2 half gallon? I can't find it. I was like, fine, I'll take the freaking 2 half gallons because I need the damn tea because Hannah's really sick and that's all she wants is tea. So I'm like sitting here and I'm like, okay, this is God. God is telling my ass, you need to stop drinking the damn tea, girl. You are getting the diabetes. You are getting the diabetes from all the sugar. So you need to stop drinking the damn tea. But I, in typical me fashion, I'm ignoring God, and I'm going to drink my damn tea. But I just wanted to share this with you, because this would be one of those things that you would really find funny. So, mwah. I love you, and I miss you, and I hope to see you soon. Bye. Hey, Scooby, it's your mom. I'm driving. Sorry, I know. The only time I'm ever alone is, like, in the car, I swear. Oh, crap. My mascara is running because I'm crying. I'm on my way to your dad's Christmas... Thanksgiving office party thing. That's why I'm all dressed up, see? I'm actually wearing makeup. Oh, my God, I know, right? But I'm just... How am I supposed to do Thanksgiving without you? Like, that was our holiday. Like, we did that shit together. Like, last year, we made the pumpkin pies together, and you helped me with everything. You made the green bean casserole all by yourself. I don't know. How am I supposed to do it this year without you? How? I don't know. I don't know how to do it without you. We always do it together. That's our tradition. How am I... I just don't know how I'm supposed to do it without you. Nobody told me that I was ever going to have to plan on doing my holidays without you. And I don't know if I can. I really don't know if I can.
I'm gonna try. I have to try for the sisters. And Nana's moving back in with us, so Nana's gonna be there for Thanksgiving, so I can't not feed her. I'd never hear the end of it. So I have to do it, whether I want to or not. I just don't know how I'm supposed to do it without you. How?